Got it. Welcome everyone, because today I know we've got and I wanted to keep it a little short because there are some, there's that big business training, and I think Allie, it's in your office and Sarah's and Tim's office. So I don't know, there's, I think, was our lunch provided too, I believe too. So that's even more fantastic. So I want to kind of just share a little bit about stuff that we have here. So we can give that to you, and let's see, share. And we'll go look at, let's go look at all the cute pictures that Madison has done for us. All right, guys, I want to talk a little bit about infrastructure here. And I know I keep discussing that a little bit, and I know what we kind of harp and keep harping it. And you're going to get to the point where I like go I listen to Jerry James over and over again, and or Tom Ferry. I go, yep, I've heard that. Oh, but yep, I've heard that. And many times we kind of like hear it and we go, but have I implemented that yet? And so that's kind of where we want to go. So I just want to share a little bit here briefly of kind of where you guys can go. There are reasons of why, I'm kind of where I'm at, and there's reasons of where my structure, where I've kind of held my team or my group of people around me. But there are things that you guys need to feel like you're not alone. And so sometimes, as we feel, I had so many people came up to me on Friday, and many emails too from individuals just saying, thank you so very much. You gave me encouragement. I was just kind of nervous. I was reading somebody on one of my groups that we're in, not part of our company, they're back east somewhere, said, hey, I've got I'm like my 9 months into real estate, and I finally got my first closing, and I counted my commission. It was like, I think he said, like after closing costs and whatever, $1,200. So he was looking for a kind of like, I feel so deflated. I still feel so like concerned, like what should I do? And there were so many people from all over the country, just get, probably like 77 messages of just hang in there, do this, here's this idea. And it was so kind of nice, because we really feel like when you guys first start, you've got your feet in the water, right? You put your feet in the water, and then sometimes it gets really cold. Maybe it depends on what ocean, or maybe you're in a hot tub, or maybe you're like freezing in the Atlantic Ocean, and you just, it's like freezing. Then you're kind of wondering that there's these sharks that are below you and stuff. Because I'm always, when we go scuba diving with my wife and snorkeling, because she's like has to do it every day when we go to some kind of water place. And so it's like I'm always looking at my shoulder, waiting for that big fish to come floating behind me. So I always put her between me and the shore. So then I'm the one that gets taken to sea. But anyway, that's a personal thing. But it's like sometimes in cases where we feel like we're in a life raft and somebody threw us something, and we're kind of hanging on, kind of like, what should I do? Where am I at? Do I continue moving forward? Then eventually you get the one sale, then you get two sales, and then you get to like, wow, look at this beautiful, and that's a really nice wood boat. Maybe you get on a boat, but maybe you don't have an oar. Maybe you don't have a, then you get like your TC could be like the oar. And then maybe your admin, now you got an admin who's helping you. Now you have two oars. Then you can like start getting direction. Then you get a rudder. And then you get this really cool, beautiful boat right down there. Jessica, it's good to see your face. Yeah, there you are. Hello. So then you get this big, beautiful boat that you actually can, cruise on. And now you have all these other tools. You get a crew. Because if you look at that boat, you can't, we can all float on the floaty by ourselves, right? We can all do that. We could probably all move a little splash. We could kind of move around our little floaty. But then, or I don't know if you guys have done a rowboat, but you know what? Sometimes it takes some coordination right there of like, oh, right. Oh, I go on a little bit more right, go a little bit left. And so you kind of, cruise through that. But then you get this big boat where now you could just be standing there at the helm and just steering the boat, and then directing all these other individuals and all these people of what to do, utilizing the people around you, utilizing Jessica and different title reps and different people to say, I need this, help me with this. And now you have this team. So what I want you to realize is that when you go into listing presentations, when you have buyer consultations, I want you just to kind of not just pitch, it's just me, it's everyone. When you go pitch a new offer to an agent, you say, this is the lender. You CC them, you have the lender call, you can have the escrow officer call. You want to present the whole entire team. So this is kind of the direction where you need to be going. This is a business that we kind of talked about last Friday, and I'm going to come back to that here in just a moment on that one. So I want to share a little bit here again, compliments of Jerry James, of you're the team leader. When you first become in, are you the bookkeeper? Are you the prospecting person? Are you the person that shows properties? Are you down here in this little green box? Are you you're doing the listing appointments? You're doing the networking? You're doing the training? You're doing the content creation? You're pretty much doing it all, right? So do you feel like you're kind of like, there'll be times I'll be going, wow, I really need to, I feel tired today. because of just so much that goes through in your brain. There's times where it gets to be 6 o'clock and I'm going, okay, it's time to go home because my head is just kind of hurting because there's just so much stuff. And so what it is, it's like saying, okay, now, but what are the first things to grow? So here's stage one. There's actually 7 steps in Jared James stages here, but we'll probably never get, you and I will probably never get to the step 6 and 7. And I'm going to show you why. It's more of a Dan Jacuzzi kind of, you'll see kind of where it goes. And it's like, maybe you don't, maybe you have the aspirations to do that. Maybe you want to be an owner of your own company. And what's just so beautiful about real estate is that you can do that. You can accomplish that. And so here you want to get your transaction coordinator. I'm pretty sure that we all have a transaction coordinator, or somebody who is helping us with the transaction right here. And I want to share a little bit there too, that we want to be a little cautious, because I've seen some new agents come in and they just, because you know those who are using are not by named person that's sitting right behind me that are using the transaction coordinator, that that you could just hand over the file and go, see you later. And you could just collect the commission check because that transaction coordinator will completely do everything for you from start to finish. Only because she was she just did that before, before we did the merger. Now there's other TCs and people that may not do as much, but I've seen too many people actually go, hey, did you read that? Oh no, I just had, that person, my TC, just send it to them to get it signed. Well, technically, guys, we need to make sure that we're reading everything and seeing everything on that. So we all have a transaction coordinator, and then we've got this admin. So now look what just happened. If you can have some type of admin, which is your front admin, they could do some of your social networking. Now, this would be somebody that you guys can hire. There's several companies out there that do some of your social media stuff, can do some of your duties, customer service, covering, showing, and open houses. And this admin, guys, it doesn't have to be a full-time person. It could be a mixture of my front desk person that's over, next door. It could be somebody who says, hey, Jessica, or one of your lenders, come play with me and be like, work with me at an open house and sit with me and kind of work with me on that. And then you got your CRM management and then you can hire maybe somebody with books. I know Tim does a really good job with all the spreadsheets and stuff. So maybe somebody can kind of do your financial reporting for you. So then you can like take some of that off. But this right here, basically a stage one that most of us are kind of probably in right now at the moment. And I love this down here. Have anybody ever take a DISC profile test about what type of personality you are? It's very, it's eye-opening. So there are, you can go to the Tony Robbins, just put Tony Robbins DISC. So I actually would people like I would meet like Jessica, people that are outgoing kind of people that are in the field of real estate, that I would have them go and do a DISC test for me, because I'd go, hey, Jessica, I really like your personality. I'm looking for a new assistant and I want her to be just like you. So can you just like take the test for me so I can then have my other future potential people take the test and see if they kind of line up and match, because I'm trying to like duplicate you. So it's really nice. So I love it that he actually comes in and actually gives you what type of task-oriented people, what type of people will be sitting at a desk, what are the type of people that want to be out in the field that are just like the people person that just, they want to talk to a billion people. So this is during the slides, it's going to show you kind of what these type of that you're looking for here. So you take the test and it will say you're more of an S and a C or a D or something of that nature. So it's kind of fun. And the DISC basically is a D, I, an S, and a C, different personalities, which is kind of fun. So here's stage one. Everybody feel like we're probably kind of get the feel and you guys got the vibe of where you're at in stage one. So what would stage two be? What do you guys think stage two? Whoops, hey, I can't skip that one. All right. So a stage two, if you're getting to the point where you're going, hey, I'm going to get busier. And I want you guys to build up to this. I want you to build this to where you guys can, we're basically creating a business here. We're wanting to create this. And so we want a buyer's agent. And then you see the buyer agent completely changed to a little bit of an I and a little bit of an S. And so we can kind of go over that, what that means. But they're doing some showings. They're doing some open houses. They're doing some lead conversions. They're making and negotiating offers. So basically you are copying and duplicating yourself. You know, there's only a few people that I would say that I've met in my life that I would say I would feel comfortable, you know, because it gets to that point where I'm saying, okay, you know, Sarah, I'm going to have you go out and take care of these buyers that are my buyers, and I want you to write the offer, and I want you to negotiate, and I want you to sound like me, and I want you to act like me, and I want you to do all this. And it's kind of like, boy, that would be, there's a lot of faith and a lot of trust in that person. And so, you know, this is where you'll start seeing what's called teams that will actually start happening. And so you're kind of pushing more stuff out to different people here and having that buyer's agent. And then it gets a little bit intriguing, and I can send all these slides to you guys if you want. That way you can kind of build, because these are things that I've been working on for, you know, just for years of just like, hey, what's next? What's next for me? Do I want to build a big team? Do I want to manage, you know, individual people? It's going to be totally up your personality. You know, I know that we had a previous agent who was one of our top producing agents, new agents that came on about 4 years ago. And now she already has a team. She already now has her own brokerage. She already has like 5 or 6 people working under her. And I did that. I totally went down this route. I bought this franchise here. I had 20 something agents that I kind of was working with and helping and training, which I did that. But, you know, 8 years of that. And, you know, I thought it was somebody else's turn. So, all right. So, you want to have, what they did here, do you guys know what the definition of an ISA is? Anybody know what heard that terminology? Cause you're going to hear it a lot lately, or we'll hear it more when you go to different trainings, but ISA is an inside sales agent, and you can actually hire them. I've hired them inside the country, outside the country. I've had people make cold calls. I've gotten calls by ISAs. I love getting calls by them, because then I go, you know, I was on the phone with one the other day and said, you're really, really good, because you make me want to buy something from you. So can I get your name and number, because I might want to hire you. So, you know, so those are the type of people that you want to attract. And that's a very, very important ISA, the I, S, and D for the DISC down here. You need to make sure to take the DISC training, because if you get the wrong personality, they're just not going to be super successful. But basically what the ISA does for you is basically makes all of your phone calls, does a lot of your prospecting for you, and then makes the appointments for you. And then you can actually pay them on a full-time basis. You can pay them on a commission basis. You can pay them straight up just, you know, per listing appointment, per sale. You know, you can structure that, which I have some structures if you guys are interested in seeing that. And so you still have your transaction coordinator, and then you have your admin, and maybe you can start seeing that they're kind of doing a little bit different kind of stuff and some job descriptions. And then your lead and buyer agent is to make negotiations offers. So you're adding a buyer, this lead buyer agent kind of in here. So you basically train this person, and then they basically train that person. And I know Jerry James and other people are very, they really like you to have 2 buyer's agents, only because that kind of gives them, you know, that drive of competition where they kind of feel like, well, if I better work hard, or Eric's going to give it to the other buyer agent and not me. So then they really work hard, and there's like different goals and different things that you set up with these people and these individuals as well. And you can see, guys, there's a big team down south in Sacramento's Carmichael that I, you know, they had a big team that kept growing, got excited. And then they finally said, guys, this is a little bit too big. And then they let a bunch of people go. And now they're just kind of refocusing and have a core of just a certain group of the original kind of team, because it does get a little bit, you know, could get crazy about kind of what you're doing. So, you know, then you've got stage 4, which is a lot more, you know, marketing and for social media, and you're bringing in a buyer agent, and now you're bringing in your marketing rep. So now somebody who's like a full-time, part-time marketing kind of rep person. Again, you guys can do a lot of this technology you can find online, because I have a lot of it online. You can get if you get a really fancy assistant like Madison, then she can actually do like a lot of these little things. And then she runs circles around you and makes you feel old. So, right?
Yeah,
she did. Yeah, she's agreeing. All right. So then, you know, stage 5, leadership. This is where, guys, it gets a little bit intense. You've got your admin, your ISA, your lead listing. So you're adding a lead listing person to go through here. I would say that somewhere in this stage is probably one of the teams that we know of in Nevada City that is probably in this kind of criteria, that they have a big staff or they have showing agents, they've got a lead person, a transaction coordinator. So they have all of these individual people doing individual stuff. And then it comes down and gives you all of the DISC profiles over here as well. And then this is where you guys will probably never get. This is a Dan Jacuzzi. This is probably give you a headache, just about where all these people, different managers, different offices, trainings, directors, team leaders, all sorts of kind of fun things. And then gets into expansion. And now you're kind of like going after real estate school instructor, like Jody, and different things, director of expansion. And so now you're just like building this, like this crazy, enterprise of office after office after office. So yeah, I just wanted to share with you guys a little bit about what these stages are, and that you don't have to do it all yourself, because, you know, eventually you are going to take in, and most of us are probably in between our little small rowboat and this ship right here. So maybe we have one that's, instead of all these sails, maybe we have a motor, and that we can just turn the key. And now we can actually rudder it ourselves with a few little lines that you guys can actually throw down. So, but that is kind of the structure of like building your business. And that's what we're going to talk about, just your infrastructure. I know we talk about that. We're going to talk a little bit more about CRMs and some things soon, just to get a little bit deeper in that, just to keep pounding that in. I had two individual agents that came up to me that were there, that been in the business a long time. And they came up and just said, you know, Eric, you've been telling me for years to get my CRM. It's all still in here and I have to get it out. I'm committing to do that for 2022. I have to get that all set up. So it's really important. Any questions about all of this, you guys, on these, on the structure? No. All right. So I'm going to give you guys a creating your little homework, because I want to keep this to 30 minutes. How many people have ever looked and found yourself on Yelp or what they're saying about you? Because I could look up Jessica right now and actually go to Yelp. If you guys all want to go share, and let's go look at Jessica on Yelp.
Yep.
I like that facial expression. Or you go to Zillow. So have you guys ever gone to Yelp to go look at maybe what people, have you ever Googled yourself and see what type of police record and stuff you have, and hope that it's not you and it's a different Eric Catch. So I want you guys, this is going to be something that I want you guys to do in the next, before January 1, I want you guys to go in here to all of your bios, to every bio, to social media, to Yelp, to MetroList. We got a lead this last month on MetroList, the people that just found us on MetroList. Who searches for a real estate agent on MetroList? But I'm telling you, it happens two or three times a year that we'll get somebody on MetroList, somebody searching through the MetroList MLS, and they actually contact you that way. And they don't, you know, I could go to MetroList right now and show you that. I think I've shared this with you, but maybe only 25% of the people even have a picture loaded on MetroList. So I need you to go to MetroList. I need you to go to realtor.com. I need you guys to go on Zillow. I need you to go on Yelp, to go on all your social media platforms, to your Instagram, on your pages and your bios and stuff, and look at them to say, what am I doing there? And I know Tim had some great things that he was working on that I could say, hey, the link is in my bio, which is great on Instagram, which is great. So keep that stuff going. But maybe that promotion, and Tim, maybe 6, 7, 8, 9 months later, that bio is outdated and or whatever, that the link he wanted was like, oops, I didn't remember I still had that in there. So go remove that. I think I've shared this before, that my kids have read a bio years ago, and it's like two of my kids weren't even on the bio, and they came up to me and says, do you love me? So, those are things that's like, oops, so I'd say that every 6 months that you have to be going in, and it could even be quarterly, to make sure that your bios are changed. Because when you guys actually send out links to Yelp and to Rate My Agent and all these type of things, actually you need to go to Rate My Agent. I don't know if they have a free version on that. I think they probably do. But if you have a bio on there, they'll actually see you better. But then when you link and hyperlink all these for your reviews, realtor.com switches their algorithms a lot. And so I'll click on there, I'll click on Yelp, and it's like, or Google too. And that's all of a sudden it's taking them to an air page. So you got to look at that. If you're sending out all your reviews with little HTML links, click here to review me, you got to go in there and check it out to make sure that they are live and ready to go. I loved it. There's a pro tip. We loved it today. Shannon actually showed this to me the other day, that somebody on Facebook posted a picture, because I know we always share, and I shared this on Friday, that you take pictures with your clients, you have a sold sign. So I put my name on the sold sign because if I don't have somebody to take the picture, then I'm out of the picture with these people. But his profile, his little picture, it was nice. He set up a little window on his computer or little picture, and it had the client with the sold sign. And then it had him down over here, kind of like it was almost blended in. It was really nicely done that it was like, hey, another house sold, but he was in like the frame of the picture, which was really nice. So it had him in it with his clients at the same time. So things like that here, I haven't seen anybody do that before. So that's a new thing that I really, really like. So find these things, you know, that you can do, but make sure you're getting your Yelp reviews and getting reviews. How many people received a review with just raise of hands, got a review this week? Anybody get a review? Say, so I don't see anybody's hands raising, but let me ask you this question. How many people asked for a review this week? It should be the lack of hands as well. So if we're not actually going and asking for review, then you're not going to get it. Keep in mind, I've shared this with you before. There's so many people that will come and go and they will not buy a house from you. They will say, sorry, I'm changing my mind. We're going to just hold still. We're not going to move. We're just going to hang tight. You go, that's so great. Do you mind helping me out? What I'd love to have it. Do you mind? It's so potent to say, would you mind? And what do most people say? Sure, be happy to. Would you mind taking a moment to actually express on Yelp, here's the link of how I've taken care of you so far, even though we haven't purchased anything and you're going to be holding tight there at your house. But I love the people, this, you know, if you could share with the words you just said, thank you so much for your time. You've been patient, blah, blah, blah. Can you copy and paste that and put that on Yelp for me? Oh, I'd be happy to. But if you don't ask, and then 2-3 days later, maybe it's like, hey, friendly reminder, you know, just friendly reminder. And so, you know, when we do those friendly reminders, we'll instantly get 2 or 3 things. This little radical girl sitting next to me, all of a sudden she's got some crazy things in regards to like rate my agent. And now all of a sudden rate my agent saying, you're almost number one. You just need a few more. So it's like driving her to start, keep sending them out to people that we closed transactions 20 years ago that I keep getting reviews from. Oh, thanks. That's really nice. All right, Sarah, you have a question?
Please. Yeah. What system do you use to get people to do video reviews for you?
Okay. I had subscribed for a free service of this one video service that I had that, and I kept sending the link out saying, guys, give me a simple, quick review, but nobody was really wanting to do that. So I have better reviews by going to like on BombBomb. It allows you to record that. So I've just, you know, they can actually record something back to you if you ask them to and say, hey, thank you so much again. Right below this, you can says there's a button right below my face that says reply per video. If you could take that and actually give me a review and just record that right back to me, then I can download that. Most of the time, I just actually grab my camera and I'm sitting out in front of the house. Okay, hey guys, thanks for taking the picture. Do you mind just saying a couple good, you know, few words? Actually, this is actually better, easier for me. If you look at my webpage, there's two profiles there that I ask them questions. Do you mind if I ask you a couple questions in the live video of like, what was your hardest thing? What was the hardest thing about buying a house? What was the hardest thing that you came up with that will help me and help other sellers that are out there looking to sell their home? So I ask these questions that it's not just like, talk about like Jessica, how wonderful she is. It's like people don't, they go like, you know, it's like, but then what will happen is when you ask that question, what was the best thing to do about buying your home? The best, the easiest thing you found? Oh, it's finding Eric Katch. That was so great. And your name just populates into the questions anyway, but I just like to ask them some deeper questions. So go look at my website and you'll actually see down below, there's a couple of them that I've asked. And so I actually had them in my back of my book. So that way, if I'm there, it's, you have them written down because I was creating kind of same templates and I wanted to ask the same questions so that I can actually start putting together videos with what here's six of my sellers that said, what is the hardest thing? So now, see what I'm doing now? Now I'm taking those little videos and I can actually create some content by putting that together. Here's, you know, 5 reasons why, blah, 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 blah. So yeah, so that's really, really good. So, but I love it when you guys get brave, like Jessica, she is so photogenic and she's like sends me videos. Sarah, you've sent me many videos and stuff and just sending me videos because then you're practicing just sending the videos. So some of us just kind of like freak out and don't want to do it, which is okay because some of the softwares you can still record your voice on the screen. You don't have to have your face, but I'm telling you, the face just makes a whole big difference when you're showing up at somebody's house and they feel comfortable already because they've already kind of seen you a couple of times. Good question though. All right. Go ahead, Sarah. I see you again.
I was typing out, like, so I'll just say it. So I am doing a 12 Days of Christmas video series where I'm highlighting local businesses in downtown Grass Valley. So I would love it if everybody went and checked it out. It's on my Facebook business page, and then I'm trying to edit them down and get them onto Instagram too, but that takes a little bit more time.
Love it. Nope. I saw that. Actually, Shannon told me that I need to watch them. So she watches that. So that's fantastic. I would be happy to do that. And you guys know that TikTok went to 3-minute videos. So you can actually create, just if you do a 3-minute video, which one of my recipes was $3, 3 minutes and 10 seconds. And so it cut off the bottom or the back end, but you actually can put it to music, which is really nice. I like the TikTok's way to create things a little easier than some other social media. Then there's another app that actually will take the TikTok logo off the bottom of your video. So if you want to know what that is, I'll have to go look what it is. But so then you can actually do the video, take off the little logo, and then repurpose that somewhere else with not having the TikTok on there. So you can let me know later and I'll tell you what app that is. But yeah, so that's kind of fun. So then you're repurposing those ads. So thank you for going out. I did some family recipes with some wassail and some of this amazing bacon. And oh my goodness, you guys will love it. But that one's coming out too. But watch those videos because you're just wanting to be you. You want to be something different. And so you just kind of have fun with doing what you want to do and your talents, and then just kind of publicize that so they can just see you in a different light. Not just like, I guess now Jaina thinks I'm funny, which is great. So now I have to practice my lines now. So it's good. All right, beautiful guys. I don't know how many people are going to their class that starts in an hour and a half, but enjoy lunch today. So I got a couple of nods and yeses. So enjoy that. Go into it. They're going to ask you what your why is. So if you want a little head start, find out what your why is and why you are in this business and why you need to make money, because they're going to kind of probably start with that. So beautiful. Anybody else have anything else they want to share or anything they want to say or any questions or concerns or thoughts that you guys have?
Hey, Eric, do you think on one of the trainings we can do like a CRM really deep dive and go through like maybe what would be good for beginner agents and kind of the different CRMs and the focuses that are there? I've been drowning and trying to find good tools.
We will do that. We will do that next Friday. That's a great one. So
okay. I know we've done system ones overall, but I thought maybe if we really focus on CRM.
We will stick on CRM. So that's perfect. We will do that. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks for going live. Enjoy the walk.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm. Perfect, guys. All right. Thank you. Jessica, why don't you hang on later and I'll chat with you for a few minutes if you don't mind. And those who want to hang on, you can do that. But I'll